Portland, actually, Maine. And we're gonna go on a little journey to find to catch lobsters.
Several buoys out in one area, and we rotate which ones we pick up. The typical amount of time before we pick up a trap is about 3 days. So that's the way gives a chance for lobsters to find the mate in the bags, and then who knows? So we don't know what's gonna be in the traps. Hopefully there's lobsters. There could be crabs, could be nothing. We do not pre-stuff our traps for you guys. That's not allowed. Yeah, you can pack the line back and then pull together. And we check that by using this measuring gauge right here. Take the first point, the hook it behind its eye, we watch where the second point hits. If this point lands up on the back, which it should, it came from our tank, it's a keeper. See how this is easily a keeper. But if it were to land down on the tail, it means its carapace is too small. It's too small to keep. So like I said, a lobster's only stuck in the trap if it's big enough to be kept or almost big enough to be kept. Smaller lobsters are able to escape out these escape vents on either side. This lobster is probably 7 or 8 years old. It takes a lobster 7 years to reach this legal minimum size. So for the first 6 years of their life, they love going in and out of traps. We're kind of training them to go into our trap, get a free meal, and then walk out. So one day they're stuck. They bump their head on the way out, and we get to keep them. So it's a really sustainable fishery in that sense, because we're feeding them until they reach our legal minimum size, keeping the population alive. Grabbing this white stripe, we gotta change out this whole thing. See how it's kind of chewed up and chummy. Let go of that, not enough to reach.
So how many days was that in there?
3 days.
3 days?
Yep. And even though not all the fish is gone, it's, you know, it's lost its oils, it's not gonna do anything anymore.
It's good.
Come over to the edge here.
Put your hand in that fish tank. Watch your hand in that fish tank. Hold on. This is how you wash your hand, fish tank. Don't do it at home.
So obviously this was way too small. You can see how this one just didn't escape yet, but it fit right out of these escape vents. So that's why we like to train these lobsters.
That one is a keeper.
So this is a very soft shell lobster. Its shell has a little bit of give, which means it recently shed its shell. They shed about once a year. That's how they grow. So throughout the year, they're growing in weight. Their meat is filling up their shell, and then once they're ready to molt, they wiggle out of. They crack open along the back and wriggle out. They have a soft paper thin shell underneath. So this one probably recently shed and is hardening up. And they lose claws mainly through fighting with other lobsters. They'll release a claw at the joint if they're threatened, but they do grow back. It'll take another year or two to get back to the full size. This one, I'm gonna measure this guy.
Yeah.
So the way we tell probably molt soon too. She's a really hard shell one.
That's pretty cool.
I'll show you how we do.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Sorry. Like I said, we take the second tail hook from the right. This is the tool that kind of gives it a little hole punch. And she's marked. That scar will get a little bit smaller every time she molts, but any demarcation on this tail flipper, Lobster will know to throw her back. All right, we can measure her.
Titan.
Lobster.
This is the lobster that we catch. We got from the boat. First main lobster. Hopefully there are many more. Oh, I have eggs inside.
Wow.
Can you focus on that? Eggs.
Are they good or bad?
Good.
Let me have it.
See? There's eggs inside.